In this podcast, we'll go over bond order, how to calculate bond order, bond energy, and its relationship to enthalpy change in a reaction. Starting with bond order. Bond order is an indication of bond strength and bond length. Simply speaking, bond order for a covalent bond is the number of bonds. If it is a single bond, then the bond order is 1. For a double bond order is 2. For a triple bond order is 3. So it's rather simple. So in F2, can you guess what the bond order is? Correct, because there is a single bond between F and F, the bond order in fluorine molecule is 1. Bond order in a nitrogen molecule is 3 because of the triple bond. So this is rather simple in valence bond theory to explain bond order, but if you have a resonance structure where you have a traveling double bond, then how do you figure out the bond order? In resonance structures where you have a traveling double bond, like carbonate, to figure out the bond order, you have to look at two specific positions. So if we wanted to know what is the bond order between carbon and this first oxygen, which is on top? Just for convenience sake, we'll number our oxygen. You can number them any ways that you want. So if you wanted to know what's the bond order between carbon and the first oxygen, what you got to do is look at, first of all, draw all the resonance structures possible for that ion or the molecule, and then between that specific position, add all the bonds and divide it by the number of structures in which all those bonds are present. So here, how many bonds do you have? You have 4 bonds that are present in 1, 2, 3 resonance structure. So the bond order is 1.33. And you can calculate the bond order for carbon and this oxygen bond the same way. And you'll notice that the bond order here is 1.33 as well. And if you were to calculate the bond order for the last one, which is over here, this CO bond order comes out to be 1.33 as well. Bond order can be a fraction. Generally, we write it in decimal to 2 places a decimal. So bond order here tells you that this double bond is a rotating bond. So the bond between carbon and oxygen in a carbonate bond is bigger than a single bond but smaller than a double bond. The reason for smaller than a double bond is because not every carbon oxygen bond is a double bond. Every carbon oxygen bond is a single bond, but some carbon oxygen bonds are bigger than a single bond. So its bond order is 1.33. Ultimately, what it suggests is in the resonance structure, the electron density is spread over, meaning the electrons are not localized, but they are delocalized and found over a larger region. Moving on to bond enthalpy or bond energy. Bond energy is defined as the amount of energy required to break a particular bond between two atoms in their gaseous state. Remember, breaking bond always requires energy, while in bond formation, energy is released. The unit of bond order is kilojoules per mole or joules per mole. Bond enthalpy or bond energy is indicative of bond strength. The higher the bond enthalpy, it means it takes larger amount of energy to break that bond, or it means the bond is stronger. Now, if you recall between a single, double, and a triple bond, which bond is longest and which is shortest? Single bond is longest and triple bond is shortest. The shortest bond is strongest because there is larger overlap, and the longest bond is the weakest. So going by that, if you had to predict which of these, single, double, or triple, will have the highest bond enthalpy, you would say that it is triple bond because it's the strongest bond, so it'll require most energy to break it. Just like for ionic compounds, the indicative of bond strength is lattice energy. For most covalent compounds, the quantity that defines the strength of a bond is called bond energy. And typically, when we talk about bond enthalpy or bond energy, we talk about average values. Because if you were to look at methane, it has a carbon and there are four hydrogens covalently attached to the central carbon. So there are four CH bonds here. So when you break methane into carbon and hydrogens, you note or measure the overall bond energy divided by four to calculate it for each bond, and that gives you average bond energy. So when we talk about bond enthalpy or bond energy, generally the values are in average bond energies. Bond energy, in addition to indicating the strength of a bond, can also be used to calculate heat of reaction or change in the energy during a reaction. You remember Hess's law, where we could calculate delta H of reaction or change in energy of a reaction by doing the energy of products minus reactants. And this in some ways is like that, except here delta H of reaction is bonds broken minus bonds formed. So bonds broken occur on the reactant side. So really delta H of reactants minus delta H of products. The best way to do these kind of problems is to write them in expanded form. It's kind of hard to see what bonds are breaking, what bonds are forming when they're written in molecular form. So if you were to write CH4 as expanded form, and Cl2 as expanded form, and CH3Cl as expanded, and HCl as expanded, it's rather easy to see that there is one CH bond that's being broken, one CLCl bond's been broken, one CCl bond is being formed, and one HCl bond is being formed. So when you calculate delta H of reaction for this reaction, for bonds broken, you'll write 1 times bond enthalpy for a CH bond, plus 1 times bond enthalpy for a CLCl bond, minus 1 times bond enthalpy for CCl bond, plus 1 time bond enthalpy for HCl bond. And that's how you can calculate delta H of reaction. So this is the solved out problem. These quantities, the bond enthalpies, are generally given to you. Another thing that I want to bring your attention to is note that two carbon-carbon bond, single bond enthalpy is not equal to one carbon-carbon double bond. The reason is two C, single bond C, do not make one C double bond C. This is a sigma bond here, and this is one sigma and one pi bond. They are not exactly double of each other. Hence, the bond enthalpy of a single bond is different from bond enthalpy of a double bond. And you cannot double the and bond enthalpy of a single bond to get the bond enthalpy of the double bond. But you don't need to worry about memorizing these values because they'll always be given to you. Now this is, thermodynamically, this is the process that's happening. So a methane, first of all, is in gaseous state and CH bonds are broken, and then CLCl bonds are broken, and intermediate species are formed. From there, bonds start forming, and a CCl bond is formed, forming CH3Cl, and a HCl bond is formed. The net transfer of energy, or delta H of reaction, is sum of energy of bonds broken minus sum of the energy of bonds formed. And that was a short podcast. Thank you for listening.